There are quite a lot of challenges. This deals with teachers, to have appropriate teachers who are trained in science, technology, mathematics. This is very critical. Secondly, the proper infrastructure. For example, issues of necessary laboratories in the science area. We need proper connectivity. We need ICT, especially these days, to be able to get information. Rwanda has done quite well, actually, in terms of putting optic fiber network all over the country. But the last mile is a problem, to be able to connect it to the schools in different areas. The cost of connectivity becomes a problem, the bandwidth. You need good bandwidth in schools, you need good bands in universities. At one time it's totally unaffordable, but now we've got optic fiber cable through the sea, undersea from Durban connected to Mombasa. We're connected to that. That has made a difference, because before that we used to use a connection through the satellite. It was very expensive. The cost was prohibitive in the past. We used to pay about $10,000 per megabit per second connectivity per month. Now it has been reduced to about $200. So that's quite at least affordable, but we're still wanting to reduce more. The other challenge is the language of teaching. Whereas in our first 2 years of primary school, students use the local language, which is Kinyarwanda. From then on, they have to use English. In the past, as you know, before genocide, they used Kinyarwanda and the French. After the war in genocide in 1994, we started using English and French. But then we realized that the graduates who come out of university really were weak in both languages of English and French. And knowing that we're joined the Commonwealth, we're joined the East African community, surrounded by English-speaking countries mostly, and the fact that the common language of business and science is English, the government took a decision to change in 2009. From 2009 January, to teach in English from third year or primary school onwards up to university level. But most of the teachers obviously were trained to use French. So we had to convert them to teach in English, and we've been carrying on. It's a long term type of activity which we teach, especially those people at the lower level. At the university level, at least, we get quite a lot of people from outside who can teach in English. But I think things are improving, but it has been a challenge. But we do realize that, and it's working. We're working on it seriously. So there are quite a number of challenges of infrastructure, issues of connectivity, issues of whatever. ICTP can do a lot of things. ICTP, its main objective, obviously, is to try and increase the capacity of science and technology, most of science, in developing countries. We are lucky now that ICTP, for example, whereas we have brought so many scientists from different developing countries to Trieste, in the ICTP, and connect them to good laboratories, connect them to very important, very good scientist. We are hoping that Rwanda will pick up, because it's one of those countries which will not exploit this. And we are trying to go and exploit it, to bring our younger scientists, and even our older scientists, to work with the renowned scientists to study and do research work. So this is one way of helping. Number two is that we are very lucky that Rwanda has been selected for a number of reasons to host the first center in Africa, ICTP, Center for Eastern Africa, and we gave the facilities and the building which is being renovated. They've been carrying out a number of activities, international studies, which have taken place in July and September. One on astrophysics and the other one on geophysics. And these ones have attracted quite a lot of people. So this is the initial activities. But the other activities, obviously, after the center is open, is to train people in at master's and PhD levels and do quite a number of research. So this is something we're looking forward to. Since it's been resident in Rwanda, we're going to try to support it as government to bring as many scientists as possible from outside to involve a lot of our Rwandese young scientists. And I think this will make a lot of difference, motivate our young scientists to do much more than that. These are the scientists who, in one way or another, can become researchers or become teachers at different levels of schooling, of our secondary schools, of our universities. And we believe that ICT, that way, will help the challenges which we are facing in training people in the area of science and technology. Try and open up your eyes, try and open up your mind to a lot of scientists who have done this good work, like in ICTP. Network with them, and it will make a difference for yourself, for the country, and for your future. And I think this is some advice which differently we have seen it. 120,000 young scientists from the developing world cannot go wrong. They have passed through ICTP. Some of them have extended to get their PhDs. A few have got a Nobel Prize out of this. And I think this will be an opening for young scientists in Rwanda, which they should look forward to.